End of enemy interlude. I knew you'd like the enemy. He's the person may pen in plastic fashion a new verse on the Helden label and colossized lot, or with his pen put pen clubs on the spot. He knows to live comes first. No bee in his bonnet outbuzzes any other that lands on it. His balance is astonishing when you consider he has never sold himself to the highest bidder, never has lived a week for 20 summers free of the drum fire of the camouflaged gunners, never has eaten a meal that was undramatic without the next being highly problematic, never succumbed to panic, cultist blood his watchword, facing ahead in untroubled mood. He has been his own bagman, critic, cop, designer, publisher, agent, char man, and shoe shiner. What he has just narrated of double dealing is nothing to what he could, of professional stealing, of the betrayal of unpublished texts to ladies, our quoddy day, and other crimes. His fate is, of course, to be a quarry of rich pickings. He's the bullseye of brain pickers like the Dickens, of unwelcome names blue-penciled in an article, caught in the act and minding not a particle. We suffer from a strange delusion, that is, that our age is straighter than was granddaddy's, of that discrimination against all writers suspected of having eyes in their heads. Good fighters, when driven in corners, are common, but here's a fellow who does not wait to be trapped, an aggressive fellow. I was sure you'd like him, and that was why I brought him. It was a piece of luck. It happened that I caught him.